Hello and welcome to my series of YouTube videos which show me making Tarra, a full body silicone fey baby. Please bear with me while I talk you through some facts about silicone doll making and excuse me for reading this from a script. My name is Carolyn Doughty. I am a sculptor and doll artist at Dreams Reborn. I also work in partnership with Jameer Graham at Our World of Chi, where we make fairies, elves, pixies and other fey babies and characters in silicone. This series of videos will be showing me making baby Tarra from a clay sculpt into a silicone baby. Part 1 in the series shows you how I make a silicone glove mould from the clay sculpt. Part 2 shows how I make a shell mother mould, cut a seam and remove the clay sculpt. Part 3 shows you how I pour a silicone baby using the mould and fix any seams or imperfections ready for painting. And part 4 and 5, which I haven't yet recorded, so we'll follow on later, will show you how I paint a baby, mat her and then root her using a fine needle and mohair. I'll be making further add-on video later showing how I sculpt a baby out of clay. The purpose of this video is firstly for entertainment, so people can see how these babies are made and how much work goes into them. Secondly, it is to help anybody who is already thinking about learning the craft or has started to work in silicone and wants to see how other artists work. As you'll see, I'm making this silicone baby by making a mould from a clay sculpt. I sculpted the baby myself by hand, so I have the right to reproduce copies of my own sculpture. It is illegal to make copies of somebody else's artwork. This means you cannot make and sell copies of anything that has not been made by you, including ornaments in your home, a child's doll, or a vinyl doll kit that has not been sculpted by you. The only way you can reproduce any doll is to either make it yourself in clay or buy a sculpture from the original artist with full permission from that artist to make copies. If you try and reproduce a doll from a doll kit and sell it or show it in any public place, such as the internet, publication or at a doll show, this is illegal as well as being immoral and unethical. If you do so, you could be sued by the original artist. Similarly, when buying a silicone doll, even a second-hand doll, always make sure you know the name of the artist who sculpted it and it has full certificate of authenticity. Finally, I want to mention the cheap silicone doll kits that are coming into the country, mainly from China. They're available on eBay and also being sold in some of the shops. The sellers are saying that they are made of silicone, some are even stating platinum silicone, but they are simply cheap manufactured silicone rubber doll kits and are nothing like the handmade artist dolls that you will buy from a doll artist. They're made out of cheap tin silicone, and if you try to use normal platinum silicone paints on them, the paint will simply peel straight off. The silicone material used is hard, brittle and could rip along creases. The product does not have a long life and in time it will break down and crumble, unlike platinum silicone which will never deteriorate. So please be careful if you're considering buying a cheap silicone doll, either as a blank kit or as a finished doll. Generally, if it seems too good to be true, then it probably is one of these cheap manufactured dolls of poor quality. Only buy a silicone baby from a reputable source, and only buy a baby that states a sculptor, pourer and reborn artist's name. I'm showing you how to make a mould from a full body baby, which has been sculpted by me. This is a fairy baby, as you can see. Well, it's a star baby. Her name is Tarra, and she's going to be made into a silicone baby. So I'm going to make the mould today, or start it anyway, and show you the different stages in making a mould. As I say, really the first job, if you want to make your own babies, is to learn how to sculpt, because you need to get to this stage. Some people do sell their sculpts, so you can actually buy sculpts with reproduction rights, which means that you can actually make babies out of them, silicone babies, because the sculptor sells them with the full reproduction rights. But other than that, unless you actually make the baby yourself out of clay, you really you wouldn't get to this stage. So I'm gonna push on. I'm gonna
what you will need is some mould silicone. Now I use Dragon Skin 10. This is a trial size. I usually just get the big gallon thingies, but it's easier as I'm working inside today to show you using the small trial size. So it's similar to the normal pouring silicone. It's in two parts, A and B, and you mix them together equal parts by weight or by volume. So I'm just going to weigh them out on my scales. Brush wise, you're better getting a brush that, if it does get if it does get manky, you can just throw it away. So I'm going to use a reasonably cheap brush. For the latest, this first layer is going to be put on very, very thinly, so it picks up all the details. Later layers, I use a thicker brush, and then I use laminating brushes. These are really cheap to buy. You can get them off eBay or from suppliers. And basically they're a bristle brush, but they're really cheap. They work out about £1 a brush. So if you do forget to wash them out, you can just chuck them away. It's not going to break the bank. So these are my laminating brushes, which I use mainly for moulding. But today, just for the first coat, I'm going to use a finer brush, because I'm going to be putting it on really, really thinly, because I need to pick up all the detail in the sculpt on the first layer. Okay, so I'm going to put scales on and weigh out equal portions of the baby wears gloves, but when I'm using sticky silicone, I do like to put gloves on, so you don't have to, it's just it stops your hands from getting sticky. There's nothing poisonous about the products. Not these ones anyway, not the silicone. But it does get sticky if you get it on your hands. Okay, so I'm going to just pour out maybe 20 ounces, something like that, of each A and B. Not 20 ounces, 2 ounces. Well, that's 1.5 ounce of A. And the same of B. Silicone is expensive to buy, so, and there is always some wastage, but try not to waste too much. I'm going to be making moulds of more than just one sculpt today, not on video, but myself, so I know I can use that up. So you give it a good stir. You don't have to degas the mould making silicone, because you're going to be brushing it on and any air bubbles are going to get popped as you go along. But you can degas it if you prefer. But as you're not pouring, you're just brushing it on. There's not the same need. This silicone, the Dragon Skin Fast, takes about, I think it's about 1.5 hours to cure. And you have about, I think, 15 minutes pop time, it says. Probably use more. It's quite warm in here today, so it probably will start to cure in an hour and a half. If you put the coats on quite quickly after each other, after it's cured or about to cure, it does stick better. You get a stronger mould. Right, what I'm going to do is put some silicone pigment in. This way I can be sure I've covered the whole sculpt. So what I do is I keep going over with the same colour until it's completely uniform all over, and I can see that there's no weaker bits. I like white because it's an opaque colour. Some of the pigments are more transparent than others, but I like white. And once I've coated it all in white, I'll go over in another colour and then another colour until I've got the thickness I want. What I'm going to be making is a glove mould. That means that I'm going to be putting a few coats, a few thin coats of silicone over the actual sculpt. I actually use a seam, some people don't, but I actually prefer to use a seam. So I'll show you how to do a seam. And then we do a hard shell over the top of that to keep the shape of the rubber mould.
So
say
this is my Tarra sculpt.
She's a fairy, so it doesn't really matter who she is or what she is for this. It's always the same. So I'm going to be just basically painting over the clay, making sure I get into all the nooks and crannies, and not getting any bubbles. It doesn't have to be thick, this coat can be as thin as you like, it's just a coating. So it's just getting a really good first layer. This layer, because it's put on thin, I'm putting it on thinly, it won't drip too much, so I don't have to worry too much about positioning of the doll. It shouldn't drip. If it does, it'll drip down onto here, and that's okay. It's just going to it can be peeled off once it's dry. This here is the pour spout, so when I actually finish the mould and come to pour it, that's where the silicone will go in. To excuse the sound of my voice today, I've just gotten over a cold, so I'm liable to coughing fits and hoarse voice. If you just keep going over it, you can make sure that there are no bubbles, no air bubbles in it. If you get an air bubble, then that's when you pour the silicone into the mould, it's just going to go into the bubble and cause a problem. So the first couple of coats have to be really nice and smooth. So she has this chi pattern on her, going through the middle of her. Obviously I can't do the top and the bottom of in one go, so I'll do what I can reach and then let it dry, and then I'll turn it over and do the bits I can't reach until it's completely sealed all over. As I say, I like to use a seam. I don't like to stretch the glove up over the body from the neck. It frightens the life out of me doing that. It's going to split or something. So I do a seam, but I have done a video on how to patch up the seam on my YouTube channel. Anybody who wants to look at that? Opted her fingers wide because I do quite like the fingers to be separate. I know a lot of babies do have their hands closed in a fist, but I like to see them reaching out for things, and even when they're asleep, like this one. So this baby is a star baby, so she's not human, she's not humanoid, and she's not a fairy, she's not going to have wings, but she's definitely fae. She's got obviously the very fae looking ears and shape of the head. I think she can look really pretty when she's finished. So these babies that we've done the chi range, they don't actually have, even though this one's a little girl, they don't actually have human type genitals. They're almost asexual. They don't really have, because they're just special babies, they're fae babies, they don't have male and female organs as such, which I think is rather nice. So I mean, if you really wanted, you could make this a boy if you wanted her to be a boy. To my mind, she's very much a little girl. The silicone's starting to thicken. Right over there on the little toes. Important I pick up all the creases. Don't get any bubbles inside those little tiny creases. I think I have covered just about every part of the top of her. Maybe, or maybe not. There are always little bits that you find afterwards, which is why I use a colour. I will be going over this again a few times for the white. To be honest, the very first coat is the most important coat. It forms the actual inner lining of the mould, which is where the pouring silicone touches. So, okay, I think we're done. Okay, so that's the first coat. As you can see, it's very thin. And that's Tarra with her first coat of moulding silicone on. Okay, I'll come back when that's cured. Hello again. Right, okay, this is dry now, it's cured. So what I'm going to do is do the back bit so that we have a complete coat all over the whole baby, all sealing her. With a very, very thin coat. Now, to do the back, obviously I can't turn her upside down because the arms will break off. So what I'm going to do is I've got this stand thing which I made myself just for this. So I'm going to zoom out a bit and show you how that works. So I'm just going to move her. Basically, this just holds her up away from the work area, but also I can place it in such a way so it hopefully avoids breaking her. So if I put her leaning across like that, hopefully that'll do it. So so I'm just going to mix up some more silicone. Okay, so I've mixed up some silicone and I'm going to do exactly the same as I did on the other side, just literally brush it on thinly, making sure there are no air bubbles, just to make sure it gets coated and make sure it covers everywhere, so everywhere on the whole of the doll, right up to the other side of the silicone, is completely coated. I'll go over with white until it's so opaque that you can't see any transparency over the whole thing, and then once that's coated, I'll change the colour and go over it with a different colour. I won't show everything that I do. I'll just show the first coat. And then you can see, then I'll show on the video how it builds up and how it starts to look when it's ready, when it's towards the end. Try not to let it drip just at this stage. You don't want too many drips. Right, I think I've virtually covered everything. It only has to be a thin layer at this stage. Apologies for the sounds my dogs are making. Right. So, I think I just leave that to cure. And then when that's cured, it should be completely sealed over the whole body. Shouldn't be any gaps at all. Okay, this is cured now, so we're ready for the next coat. So I'm just going to do the same thing again, just another coat, another thinnish coat of silicone over that, in the same way. I'm not going to video it all, but basically I'm just going to go over it, the whole thing again, do the same thing again, and then I'll probably do it again maybe a third time until it's coated. You do get the odd drip, you can just snip those off until the whole thing is absolutely coated. So I'm gonna mix up some more silicone and do another coat over the whole thing. And eventually you won't be able to see any of the sculpt through, it'll just be completely opaque white, and then I'll know that I can go on and do the next colour. I'm gonna do that, and I won't bother videoing the whole thing, but I'll put the video back on towards the end. Okay, I flipped it over again. And just coating this side once more. Once this is done, I think I'm going to change colour so I can see again what I'm doing. So the main object of this at the moment is still to get just a really good coating, a really good first coat on. It doesn't have to be thick, although I am going a bit thicker than I was earlier. I don't think any two people actually make moulds in exactly the same way, so you may find that other people do it slightly differently, or very differently. There's no right and wrong way, so it's just how I do it, and I'm certainly not perfect. Right, I'm going to leave that to cure now, and I think that's the whole of the white coat done. I'll change colour for the next coat. Okay, that's all cured now, so what I'm going to do is mix some more silicone but give it a different colour so I can see what I'm doing. So, same as before, this is a more transparent pigment than the white, so I'm never going to get it opaque. But that's fine, you can still see how thick it's going on. Busy stick. Doesn't matter how much pigment you put in, it's just so that you can see what's going on. So I'm going to use my laminating brush for this. So it's not, we don't have to take as much care getting it into creases and that, because we're basically just layering it up now. Better not to have too many drips, but we're just going to slap it on, because from now on we're just going to be layering, getting it thicker and thicker and stronger and stronger. I use this Dragon Skin 10 Fast because it does cure quite quickly, and I like to be able to layer on top of it as quickly as I can. Once I'm doing a mould, I like to get it done. Some people find it is far too quick, they prefer the medium or even slow, which can take a few hours to cure, but I find this is perfect for me. Again, try not to get any bubbles in it, especially in the thicker bits, because bubbles just weaken the mould, get into all the little creases and things, nooks and crannies. Try to only mix enough silicone for what you need, because it is expensive and it's very easy to waste it. Okay, I'm just finishing off the first coat of the pink, but I'm just showing you, I'm going to thicken it up. I mean, else it'll drip off, but just over the area where I'm going to be doing the seam, which is down the back of the head from the pore spout, and down the back. Just every time I do a coat, I'll thicken it up, or rather I'll go over it thickly. I'm not actually adding any thickener at this stage, but the better the thicker the coat, the better the seam's going to be. Okay, still going strong. I'm doing the second coat of the pink. So again, I'll coat this so that it's virtually, so all the transparency bits that you can see the white through are coated, and then I'll go on to a different colour. Again, I'm slapping it on a bit thicker now. Try not to let it drip too much, but as long as it coats it really well, it doesn't matter too much. I'm not picking up detail at this stage, I'm just thickening the mould up. Okay, I'm just about to start the final colour of silicone. I'm going to use... Right, I'm going to start my final coat of silicone. Right, I'm going to start my final coat of silicone, or final colour. This one I'm going to do in green, so I'm just mixing up some green silicone. I'm going to do one thin coat over the whole thing, and then I'm going to thicken it up using thick soap. Just to give it some strength, and the mould will hold its position, its shape a little bit better. So I'm just going to start layering this on. New brush out because I forgot to wash that one off. Okay, so same as before, just brushing it on. Reasonably thickly, but not so thick that it's just going to drip all over the place. There we go, that's the first coat of the green gone on. On the top side, looks a bit blue or purple in the video, but it's green. Okay, so I'm going to leave that to cure and then turn it over and do the the back of it. Okay, I'm ready to do the thickened layer now. So I'm going to put the thickened layer on the parts of the sculpt that are more fragile, it gives it more strength, and also on the seam. So I'm going to do this a different colour again. So I'm adding some black pigment so that I can see where this thickened layer is going on. Now, to thicken the silicone, I use thixotropic agent, which is called Thivex. You just add a tiny amount, and it basically makes the silicone so that it's not like really thick, but it's not runny either, so it's not going to drip basically. It doesn't make it solid, but it takes that dripping out of it. But it does make it a little bit more air bubbly. So on the seam, that's where I like to get the first sort of like quarter of an inch down with ordinary silicone before I start putting the thickened silicone in. So that's the silicone mixed, I'm just going to add a few drops of the 5X. Just a few drops at a time. Now it should be able to more or less hold its shape when I apply it. There we are. So you might be able to see, you probably can't, but it is actually, if I was to pull it up the side of the beaker, it's not going to run down. Okay, I've done a coat of the thickened silicone on the one side of the baby, so I've turned it over. I'm going to do the back now, and the seam as well, so I'm going to show you how to do the seam. Incidentally, you don't have to thicken the mould, the glove mould, for smaller babies. This is the butterfly baby that I've been moulding along the same time. I've thickened the back here ready for the seam, but I've actually not thickened the other bits for this one, because I want to have it quite floppy and be able to turn it inside out. So you have to use your own judgment really on whether you're going to thicken it or not. Some people don't thicken them at all, but I do like to thicken them because it does give them some extra stability. So I'm going to just paint over the areas that haven't been painted on the other side, but also start to build up the seam. As I said before, not everybody uses seams. I prefer to use a seam because I once got a baby. I tried to do a glove mould on a preemie baby without using a seam when I first started doing glove moulds, and she got stuck. I couldn't get the neck seam over the body. I was hours, and in the end I ended up having to cut it in the end, so it's not ideal to cut the glove mould without actually preparing the seam beforehand, because then you end up with a very thin seam that you can't put together easily. When you do a seam on a mould, when you pour the baby, there's always some touching up to do, but I'll show you how to do that as well. Because you never get the seam absolutely perfect. Well, maybe some people do, but I never do. But when you've finished touching it up, it shouldn't be visible at all. So I do the seam right down the back from the paw spout, right down the back of the head and down the back up to the top of the bottom. That's how I do it anyway. So I'm putting this on reasonably thickly because it's been thickened anyway. It's really a horrible colour, this one. I don't know why I chose to use black pigment. It's revolting, but it doesn't matter. Right, okay, that's more or less covered. Right, what I'm going to do now is start building up the seam. I'm just going to slap this on with a palette knife. I'll probably do it in two layers the seam. There is some movement, as you can see, it does start to kind of trickle, but on the whole it keeps its shape. And I want it at least an inch wide, and probably the same deep really. To give some stability. Probably be deeper in some places than others. Not sure whether the video is actually picking this up with it being such a horrible dark colour. And then I do it quite thick where the seam is going to get parted over the bottom area here. It needs to be reinforced because it can split as you pull the thing apart. The silicone with thixo in it, the Thivex, it does take longer, a little bit longer to cure than the silicone on its own. It's still fairly fast. Okay, alright, I'm just going to leave that. That's the first layer of the seam. Okay, I'm going to leave the seam, but what I'm going to do with the rest of it is I'm going to get my brush and dip it in to silicone fluid to smooth it out a little bit, because the smoother the overall finish is, the easier it's going to be to fit the mother mould over the top, the shell mould. So what I'm going to do is get some silicone fluid, which is, I've got some in here, not very much, and just smooth it so that those brush strokes are nice and smooth. I'm not going to touch the seam for now. Do that at the end. Okay, I've got the final mix of thickened silicone. I hope it's the final one, which I'm going to put just on the seam. Okay, this is more or less cured. Well, I think it has cured actually, it's firm. So I'm just going to apply it fairly thickly. I'm wondering if it needs a bit more thixo in that. I'm running out of 5x, so I'm being a bit mean with it really. If you put too much in though, it does affect the cure. See, that's, I don't know if you can see it, but it's slightly moving. I don't really want any movement, I want it to hold its shape. So I'll put some more thickener in. Okay, that's better, I think. Right, I'm just going to use the silicone fluid just to smooth it off and see what sort of a shape I've got. I've probably got a good sort of half inch there. Let's see if I can build it up at the top a little bit more. I may go in and add another coat after this is cured. Anyway, that'll do for now. There we go.